Premier Isko. And I think that the R2 reclamation, it was solid voice before. It was an ugly mountain of Kirby, then it became a real estate project. So my question is, why don't you get some of the solid waste and use it for land reclamation? China is, stealing land from many, buying many land just to have land reclamation in the ocean. Maybe you can expand Manila by having expanded land reclamation using solid waste. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Una, just to be consistent, if I can turn back time, if I was the mayor then, I will not sign that contract regarding reclamation. But you know, there is what you call also in business, stability and certainty, especially when there's change of administration. You really have to respect contracts. Be careful in addressing this type of contracts entered into by your predecessors. Ako, may pagkilala naman ako sa batas. Kaya, whatever contracts that they have signed with regard to reclamation in Manila, basta ako passive, as long as they will comply with rules and regulations, issuances of the national government, then so be it. But I, for one, will not extend any more further just to have a commercial complex like BGC in the west part of the city, except for, if given a chance, I hope, like in the case of ADI and ICTSI, and North Port, with regard to Pier 2 and Pier 4, and I've been telling them, if given a chance, reclaim that portion of port to make it a logistical hub so that trucks will not go outside of the port. Like, I was fortunate enough to be sent to Hong Kong port, and I studied, and nag-money-money ako, sort of saying. Magtataka ka sa Hong Kong, one of the busiest port, pero walang truck sa Hong Kong. Pasirin ninyo, walang porti-porter na lumalabas because there's a logistic hub inside the port. So I want to create more space to create logistic hub so that there will be less, more 40-footer trailer na mas matindi pa kung magbugay ng usok sa pabrika ng isang plastic company. So that's why with regard to reclamation, the only exception is the industrial part of the city to address environmental problem with regard to our air pollution brought by X number of trucks flying by the east or the western road of the city. Now, again, go back to reclamation na yung tinampak nilang basura. Ano yung sabi niyo, Manunay? Yung basura tinambak nila sa, pwede yung basura itambak sa lupa, sa dagat. And that is more hazardous. I am not a technical guy. Because I believe, bilang basurero, may methane yun eh. Inilihak nga namin yun araw-araw eh. We are immune to methane na air. Kaya, modesty aside, may awa ang Diyos, in a few weeks from now, about 3 months ago, I asked an institution, literally, commission a study. Hopefully, you will come up with a result on with regard to the effects of methane of the old Smoky Mountain. Because there's an old garbage there. Baka hindi nyo lang, baka nakakalimutan yun, ha? It's still part of our geography, in the northern part of Tondo. Thanks to President Ramos, he made some portion of it to address ISF in that area, no? And, they have now decent living, and thanks to former President Macapagal Arroyo, thanks to former President Ninoy Aquino, tuloy-tuloy yung development. Thanks to all those presidents who are giving in city there, I mean housing, but still, ando doon pa rin yung Smoky Mountain. At pag umuulan, kaya ako siya tinawag na Smoky Mountain, just so you know, pag umuulan, I don't know, eh, may mga scientists, pag naulan, umuusok. Oh, because of the chemical reaction, maybe, of that campus. And I cannot allow, and I will not allow, and I swear to God, I don't have facts, but logic will dictate the moment. So I will not allow that garbage to be thrown in our water. No way. Puro plastic yun, baka akala ninyo. Mukha lang siyang lupa. Pag pinalam ninyo yun, mukha ng dami ng plastic doon, limasin ko. Kasi yun yung plastic, bilang basurero ako, yun yung plastic na hindi nabibili sa junk shop. Ang kinukuha namin basura, yung PE. Kasi yung PE ang nabibenta ulit. Pero yung magaspang na plastic, oh, yung pinagbalutan ng damit, oh, hindi yung nabibili. Yun, nandoon yung sa smoke. So, if you are addressing plastics in our waters, then we are going to reclaim using this type of garbage or this type of mass. Nagdagdag ka rin. Para lang may isang politiko yan eh. Nagtapong muna ng basura bago din ang puti basura. So, I'm not that type of politician. Or, I have respect with other politicians. I always try to address situation in a very practical, most if no, there's a way to be more efficient and quick. Because I think there are presentations here that we're losing time. So we have to catch up with time. So, gusto ko sinabi mo kanina, yung unang tanong nandiyan ako. We don't need any more laws. There's too much laws in our country. Yeah, dami ng batas. The question is, we, kami nila Joy, ako, mga executive or local citizen, because it's yan yung portion ng gobyerno, magpapatupad. Napapatupad ba namin yung mga batas na yun? Because batas lang yan na naisulat, kung hindi yan ipatutupad, baliwala yan, nagkukwentuhang laway lang tayo. So I don't think that there will be more laws needed to address this problem. In fact, we have enough. And I think, I hope, the national legislatures use the power of oversight instead of the power to legislate. Are these laws being implemented properly? Because, buti nga si Joy, meron na silang yung rules na hindi, kailangan na you follow this ordinance before the issuance of permits, regulatory measures. Kami, go there. Basta lilinisin ko muna yung kalye. Tuturuan ko yung tao na huwag maging dugyot. Huwag tayong maging salaula. Siguro we start with that. And kami naman natutuwa dahil unti-unti, Cemex, Republic Cement, Unilever is helping us. I think for the past 1 month, if I'm not mistaken, no, we've gathered 42 tons no, of plastic. Can you imagine that in 1 month? And I'm only in my 5 months. So what more you can do with private sector? So kayong mga nakikinig dito, halika kayo lang sa Maynila. Apo, welcome kayo lahat sa Maynila, like what Unilever is doing, like Cemex and I think Republic Cement is doing. Everybody is welcome to help Manila. Rest assured that the Manila government will be more, nowadays, more receptive. Because we've been working hand in hand with the DNR, the national government. Alam mo, ito nga pala. Mabanggit ko lang. Total, sa chance ko na. Niawa ang Diyos. Niawa ang Diyos. You know, I was fortunate to listen to DNR in a meeting. They gave me an idea. that for Manila to be ecologically sound, we need to make open green space, 1,600 hectares of open green space. That's what they said, thanks to them. And with that, now we have a goal, we have a target. And I asked them, is that the horizontal alone? Sabi sa akin, what do you mean, sir? Horizontal, di ba? Pagtatanim ng puno, pag kinukwenta nyo ba o kinukwantify nyo, pahalam lang. Bakit? Because I have an idea. You know, in a civil, in a modern world, they are now utilizing space vertically. That's why, sabi na, we'll quantify it. Well, that's why you can, I hope, Ma'am Noy, pumasyal kayo sa Jones Bridge. You will see na yung aming pagkilos, because that is the focal point of vertical greens in the city of Manila. That is the testing ground. Pinaka-polluted, mainit, walang source of water. Bridge has no source of water. Yan ang na-hammer. Doon kami nag-hammer test because we're gonna build more green space. That's why I'm taking back parks, open space, creating more greens in the city of Manila. I think I'm happy that the national government and mga gentlemen here are now addressing plastics in waters, wastewater, and with Manila Water is doing. In our own little way, ang participation namin sa inyo, pipilitin namin maging malinis ang hangin sa lungsod ng Manila, particularly the Lotto. And I'm grateful to 3M. They're going to provide us X number of AQM. I'm grateful to DNR. They're going to give us 2 heavy-duty AQM. Because ang tubig may science na para maging malinis. Simula sa pinakamaruming tubig, dumaan sa science, sa makina, sa dulo, pwede mo nang inumin. So ang tubig, pwedeng i-cure. Pero wala pa ako nakita ang pwedeng makina na maglilinis ng hangin sa pangkalahatan. And I think the best way to do it is to create more plants and trees. I think, in a long-term process. So, yun lang, Ma'am Noy. Pasensya ka na, talagang I'm not for reclamation. It's just that merong kontrata, itutuloy nila yung reclamation. Sinabi halimbawa ng national government, okay, approved by ECC, pinag-aralan, ligtas, hindi makapapamisala sa kapaligiran, then we'll go for it. Other than that, the 5 contracts signed by my predecessor, I don't know why they are now overlapping. They're overlapping among each other, those contracts. Other than that, no more, please. Spare naman Manila Bay. Ganda-ganda naman mga labas na. Pero yung nagagabihan ang dito, sayang, papasalamatan ko sa personal. Because you will be surprised on what they did via Ross Boulevard. Creating a development that will address dirty water, makina, o yung ginawa nila bago lalabas sa Manila Bay na malinis na ito. Maraming salamat sa DNR. I think it's going to be finished in a couple of weeks now. May awan ito. So I wish you well and you will support. So thank you, sir.
Thank you, Mayor Esco Moreno.